Fiona, it's amazing to have you here with us today. Can you talk about, of all the accolades that have been heaped upon this amazing piece of work, what collecting today's award means to you guys?
I think it's a very special award because it's already decided in advance, so it's a marvellous feeling. There's no tension, there's no sense of loser. I think what is remarkable about Killing Eve is that when we were in America recently, you know, there are 500 brilliant television series, all written by brilliant people. And this little show, you know, from Sid Gentle and BBC America, has just, you know, just like a little bubble in a torrent, has just come up to the top. And it's surprising, it's marvellous, and it just says something about if you really capture the human imagination and you really deliver on the human imagination, the comeback is fantastic.
Talking about fantastic, the series is obviously built around two astonishing performances from Joni and Sandra. Can you talk a little bit about each of them and what makes them both such very special performers, particularly in these roles?
I could write a book about that. I think Jodie is, you know, one of those glorious things that comes along every now and then, because she is open. She's so open. She's like a sort of flower, and her facility is phenomenal. She can do accents, she can do languages, and she can turn on a sixpence. She's very free. And Sandra is a completely different type of actor. She works very, very hard and is very disciplined, eats very carefully, in that she's always eating, actually. We're always eating on the set. And she's always worrying about the plot and always worrying weeks ahead, as we all of us have to worry weeks ahead, because you, one flicker of an eye here might have reference to something later. So they both, they're complementary and good-hearted and concentrated. It's hard work, you know. There's a lot of scenes.
Just finally, obviously, after an astonishing first season, fans are so excited looking to the future and the continuation of that story. What can fans generally expect, and what are you most excited personally about getting to continue with these characters?
Well, I mean, at the end of season one, I suppose the world had gone slightly mad.
Yeah.
Some of it steadies and some of it absolutely doesn't. You're going to get more of something. You know, it goes in another direction, and that's what these series do. So you can expect a good time, I hope.